The James Webb Space Telescope is the most advanced and groundbreaking camera that mankind has ever created. You might be wrong if you believe that the JWST was simply put into orbit to capture breathtaking images of the universe. James Webb is capable of much more than that. The telescope is at the forefront of modern astral research. The telescopes, which are located outside the Earth's interfering atmosphere in space, often provide us with detailed insights into completely alien worlds. The scientific community has placed great faith in this telescope. The JWST is extraordinary, and state-of-the-art tools serve as a guarantee for the confidence, one of which is the NIRSpec, or Near Infrared Spectrograph. The instrument allows scientists to record the light spectra from about 100 planets simultaneously. One of the science programs that uses NIRSpec is dedicated to identifying the possibility of alien life in the universe. NASA claims, however, that James Webb might just have done so. Scientists have found evidence of carbon dioxide on WASP-39b, an exoplanet located 700 light-years away from us. Could this be the solution to the age-old mystery of alien existence? What exactly has the JWST found? Finally, and most importantly, can we finally expect to see the first images of aliens? Together with you, we are looking for answers today. Join us as we dive into James Webb's new discovery that could finally prove aliens on WASP-39b. Few discoveries are as fascinating as the discovery of proof of alien life. Life is undoubtedly one of the most beautiful aspects of the universe. The foundation of life is made up of four elements: carbon, oxygen, hydrogen, and nitrogen. In essence, researchers look for these components anytime they wish to locate aliens. But how do they detect these elements in the first place? Here's the scoop. Because extrasolar planets and exoplanets are so far away, astronomers cannot directly establish their properties. To determine the planet's features, scientists employ a range of indirect methods. For example, a smaller planet will block less light than a giant planet when it transits its star. This allows us to estimate its size. However, in order to find aliens, we must understand the exoplanet's atmosphere. For this one, scientists employ some ingenious strategies. Every planet and other celestial body in the universe, with the exception of black holes, absorbs and transmits a certain amount of the light that it gets from its star. Different wavelengths of light are absorbed by various molecules in the atmosphere. Scientists can divide this light into its spectrum of wavelengths and determine which ones have been absorbed. Dark molecular bands serve as chemical fingerprints that can be read, revealing the chemical makeup. This is exactly what the James Webb Space Telescope has done this time. NASA's James Webb Space Telescope has discovered the first conclusive proof of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere of a planet outside the solar system using spectrographic techniques. This observation of a gas giant planet 700 light-years from the Earth, orbiting a sun-like star, sheds light on the planet's makeup and developments. The planet WASP-39b is a hot gas giant, with a mass nearly equal to Saturn, but a diameter around 1.3 times bigger than Jupiter's. Unlike our solar system's cooler, more compact gas giants, WASP-39b orbits incredibly close to its star, only about 1/8 the distance between the Sun and Mercury, completing one round in just over 4 Earth days. This fact alone eliminates the potential of life on the planet, because it is far from being in the Goldilocks zones. According to scientists, WASP-39b is devoid of life. At least, the life as we know it. Its high temperature, which is approximately 1600 degrees Fahrenheit or 900 degrees Celsius, also indicates that the number of extremophiles on the planet may be minute at best. But how did the JWST find WASP-39b in the first place? The planet was discovered in 2011 as the result of ground-based observations of the subtle, recurring lowering of its host star's light when the planet transited or passed in front of the star. Other telescopes have already observed the presence of water vapor, sodium, and potassium in the planet's atmosphere, including NASA's Hubble and Spitzer space telescopes. Webb's unrivaled infrared sensitivity has now proven the presence of carbon dioxide on this planet as well. To observe WASP-39b, the study team made use of Webb's Near Infrared Spectrograph, or NIRSpec. The presence of a subtle hill between 4.1 and 4.6 microns in the resulting spectrum of the exoplanet's atmosphere gave the first unequivocal, precise evidence for carbon dioxide ever discovered in a planet outside the solar system. According to NASA, a transmission spectrum of an exoplanet between the wavelengths of 3 and 5.5 microns has never been measured by any observatory with such delicate variations in the brightness of so many distinct colors. Scientists believe that access to this portion of the spectrum was essential for detecting the abundance of gases like water and methane, as well as carbon dioxide, which are believed to exist in a variety of exoplanet types. Although ecstatic for the scientific community, the finding of the planet's close proximity to the Sun disappointed those expecting aliens. Finding life in a neighboring star system is a daunting task that requires constant tolerance and rejections. Still, in 2016, researchers found a planet that was remarkably hospitable. The planet named Proxima Centauri b, or simply Proxima b, was found to be present in its star's Goldilocks zone. The planet is also only 4.24 light years away from Earth, and its size is just 1.17 times that of Earth. The planet's surface temperature is also approximately 0 degrees Celsius, which is quite comfortable considering people on Earth exist in even more extreme locations where temperatures drop below negative 50 degrees Celsius. Proxima b could be both a rocky, terrestrial planet like Earth and have liquid water due to its mass, which is similar to that of Earth. Proxima b revolves around a star that is significantly fainter and less massive than the Sun. It's also unknown whether Proxima b has an atmosphere. However, if Proxima b does have an atmosphere, the basic components that are required for the emergence of the biochemical cycles that constitute life, water, carbon dioxide, and rock could all be present and interacting on the planet's surface. The planet orbits its star once every 11 Earth days while being extremely close to it. The exoplanet has a light side and a dark side, with one side constantly facing the star and the other always facing away, since it is tidally locked and rotates synchronously with its star. If Proxima b is inhabited by aliens, it's thought unlikely that life could arise on the day side because of a steady stream of powerful radiation from its host star. The reasoning is that Proxima b orbits the Sun at a distance of only 4.5 million miles, or just a tenth of the distance Mercury travels when it is closest to the Sun. If you don't already know, radio signals have already been detected from the area around Proxima b. However, radio astronomers assume that they were probably mere noises from other sources. Scientists believe that for a conclusive indication, any civilization inhabiting the exoplanet may need to deploy strong mirrors or use extremely brilliant LED-style lights to illuminate their cities, because the side of the exoplanet that is free from radiation is constantly dark. If we use the correct tool, it can assist us in finding them. According to researchers, the JWST might be set up to look for Proxima b's LED lights. They anticipate that they can identify this artificial light if it exists by utilizing the near-infrared instruments on the James Webb Telescope and looking for the telltale signals of LED light waves in the light from the planet and its host star. By calculating the light curves from the planet and its host star, the scientists hope to explore the possibility of finding artificial lights on Proxima b's dark side. These scientists considered two different scenarios: artificial illumination with the same spectrum as commonly used LEDs on Earth, and a narrower spectrum that leads to the same proportion of light as the total artificial illumination on Earth. They learned that the JWST would be able to pick up artificial light similar to LEDs that make up 5% of stellar power. But in order to evaluate whether or not the light curves match those of an LED light source, researchers will use devices in the observatory to measure the amount of energy that is transported around the planet. Because of JWST's immense power, scientists predict that it will be able to prove the presence of artificial illumination with a size comparable to that of our planet. The Webb telescope will offer unprecedentedly detailed observations over a broad range of wavelengths, thanks to its 6.5-meter mirror, which is larger than Hubble's 2.4-meter mirror. NIRISS, or Near Infrared Imager and Slitless Spectrograph, which is a Canadian instrument, will be one of four that will observe in the infrared range and describe the atmospheres of a variety of exoplanets. The Webb telescope will enable us to use the mapping techniques at our disposal to gauge the extraterrestrial atmosphere's three-dimensional variants. Thanks to these measurements, we will be able to learn more about atmospheric processes. So, if humanity ever decided to leave Earth and shelter for a new home, this planet must be it. But in the unlikely event of an emergency evacuation, Mars would be the sole option for human rescue. Elon Musk established SpaceX because he thought NASA could be doing more to bring people to Mars, and that the Earth would one day turn into an uninhabitable wasteland. Elon Musk claims that his lifeboat, officially known as the Starship, can accommodate roughly 100 people at a time. I'll leave the math to you to figure out how many rounds it would take to transfer all of humanity. Even though Mars is 140 million miles distant from Earth, it nevertheless experiences a reasonable amount of sunlight and cold, which people may warm up. Mars is one of the nearest livable planets to Earth. Humans can easily produce plants by compressing the Martian atmosphere. Note that most of the atmosphere is composed of CO2, along with some nitrogen, argon, and other gases. As a matter of fact, the gravity is about 38% of what it is on Earth. Facts demonstrate that humans can readily adapt and exist on Mars. However, Elon Musk stated in an interview that the first inhabitants of Mars would, unfortunately, pass away after completing their mission and living out their lives. Mars colonization will probably take years, but it will be worth the wait in the end. By the way, what are your thoughts about this? Do you think humans should look out for aliens? Let us know what you think in the comments section below. Thank you for taking the time to view this video. I hope you really liked it. Consider subscribing to the channel if you liked the video. And as always, thanks for watching.